Hey, what's up everybody? This is Sam, and welcome back to the Introducing Stack View series. In this part of the series, you'll learn about some of the more advanced configuration options available within a stack view, allowing you to build the exact layout you're looking for. This is what the app will look like when you've completed this part of the series. You'd already built this great layout in the last video, but if you try rotating the device, you see it really doesn't work that well with compact vertical size class. That vertical stack view just doesn't have the space to fit all the content in. What you're going to do is learn about how the stack view deals with adaptive layout, in addition to one or two of the more complex features of UI stack view. Before we dig into some of the more complex features of stack view, I want to cover some of the really powerful properties you've already seen in a bit more detail. First up, alignment. Alignment specifies where the elements, the subviews, will be positioned perpendicular to the axis of stacking. For example, in a vertically stacked stack view, you could have your elements over on the left, in the center, or on the right. Correspondingly, in a horizontally stacked stack view, elements could be aligned along the top, in the center, or along the bottom. There are three more examples that are incredibly powerful, but a little less intuitive. First of all is fill. Fill is incredibly useful. What that will do is stretch each of your subviews to be the same size as the stack view itself. So no longer will it be aligned over on the left, it will be stretched or compressed to match the entire width of the stack view. This is really powerful and is used all the time. The other two are very specific for text handling. You can have it so it aligns at the top baseline, that's the line that goes under the top line of text, irrespective of size, and that's the powerful part. And finally, you can use the last baseline. That's the equivalent to the very last baseline in a multi-line or single line label. Next up, distribution. Whereas alignment works perpendicular to the axis of stacking, distribution works along that axis. It says, given that a stack view is a particular size, which may be determined by auto layout, how do I lay out the elements within it? The first option is just to stretch one of them to make sure that you fill the entire space. This will either be stretched or compressed to fill the available space. To determine which element is going to be stretched or compressed, we return to auto layout, the content hugging priority and the content compression resistance priority, just standard things you've had in auto layout for ages. Similar to fill is fill equally, where it's just going to make each view identically sized along the axis. If you have a vertical stack view, they'll each have identical height, and in a horizontal one, they'll each have identical width. Next up, fill proportionally is similar. Here, each view has an intrinsic content size, and auto layout will adjust their size proportional to this intrinsic content size. Now, two that don't change the size of the views themselves, but rather the spacing. First, equal spacing. This ensures the spacing between each of the views will be identical. As the stack view changes size, the spacing between the views will get bigger or smaller appropriately. The final one is a little bit different. It adjusts the spacing, but rather than keeping the spacing of the edges of the views the same, it instead makes sure that the centers of the views are equally spaced. This can sometimes be really helpful to create a layout that looks naturally pleasing to the eye. And now onto two of the more advanced properties on UI stack view. The first, layout margins relative arrangement. This allows you to use the layout margins property, which was introduced on UI view in iOS 8, to position the subviews of a stack view relative to the layout margins rather than the edge of the stack view itself. It's a Boolean. Set it to true if you want to use the layout margins. The default is false. The final property is baseline relative arrangement. This is to do with the spacing between subviews, particularly those that contain text. Rather than using the edge of the view, it uses the baselines, the bottom baseline for the bottom and the top baseline for the top. This can result in arrangements that look a lot more natural when you're dealing with text.
This image shows how we want the view controller to look in a compact height situation. You can see that the map is now on the right-hand side of the rest of the details section. Now, have a look over at the document outline as it currently stands. You'll see that there's a stack view here that contains the name label, this yellow bar, the details label, and the map view. We're not going to be able to use that stack view as it currently stands to create this layout here. What we need to do is stack these three items, the name label, the yellow bar, and the details, in its own stack view, so that then this outer stack view then has two items in it. And then all we need to do is determine the axis, horizontal or vertical, determined by the vertical size class. So let's go ahead and do that. Head on over to the main storyboard, and as ever with building stack views, select the name label, the yellow bar, and the details label, and then hit the stack button. Straight away, that's created a stack view. It's not made any difference to the appearance because the stack view has retained exactly the properties that we need it to. Now, however, you can see that this outer stack view, which contains the details and the map and stuff, only has two items in it. This is exactly what we want. We want them to be, as they are here, vertically, when there's enough vertical space. However, when it's compressed, the vertical size class is compact, we want to switch that axis to horizontal so that they appear side by side. With this stack view selected, the one with the map and the inner stack view on it, open up the attributes inspector. And you'll see that next to the axis property, in fact, next to all of the properties of the stack view, there's this little plus, this size class override button. Tap that, and you can see that I can add a size class customization in exactly the same way that I have been able to in iOS 8. I want to say any width and compact height. And then with that, I just change the vertical axis to horizontal. Fantastic. Now, build and run. And if I go into an example while it's in standard height, that's looking good. And if I go back and rotate, and then head in again. Now that we've got compact height, it has indeed switched that axis. We've now got the details appearing next to the map. However, the map is very, very small. It's not quite what we were after. The reason for this is that the stack view on the left-hand side has an intrinsic content size that's much bigger. It's quite happy to go as large as it possibly can because the map isn't arguing back for a load of space. Now, the way that we want this to appear in this particular example is actually we want both of them to be the same size, which a stack view can do really easily. Head back to the storyboard. And on this stack view here, again, we're going to need the little plus by the side. Remember, the distribution determines how the size of the objects appear along the axis of the stack view. Again, I need to add a size class override because I don't want to change it as it currently is. So any width, compact height. And I want to change fill to fill equally. Fill equally, remember, means that every item within the stack view will have the same size. Build and run again. There you go, that's now perfect. Notice that now this section is taller, it's required to be taller to fit all of the details in, and that's pushed the image up off the top. That's absolutely fine. We've got the map on the right-hand side, that's exactly what we wanted to do. Great. To continue exploring some of the more advanced properties of a stack view, we're going to turn your attention back to the About view controller. So if I head back, and just remind ourselves what it looks like, this is very similar to where you left it after the challenge of the first video. We've just added a yellow background bar in the same way that you did in video 2. But other than that, it's exactly the same. And what we're going to look at in this section is how to increase the margins around the stack view. You'll notice at the top and the bottom, there's not much space. It'd be great if we could have a bit of margin around there. So in the storyboard, move up to the About view controller. Here it is. And within there, if you select the stack view and look at the attributes inspector, there's this property called Layout Margins Relative. And in actual fact, that is all you need to do. That's everything that there is there. However, it doesn't quite work. Let's explain what it does, and then we'll see how we can get around the fact that it's not currently working. Since iOS 8, all UI views have had a layout margins property, and this provides an inset within the UI view from which auto-layout constraints can be applied. StackView, as a UI view subclass, is no different. It has these layout margins as well, but it doesn't use them by default when organizing its layout, when laying its contents out. Checking this box, this layout margins relative, will allow the stack view to use those layout margins when calculating its layout. However, in this particular build of Interface Builder and Xcode, this doesn't appear to be working. So you can check this box and run it up and nothing happens. So what we're going to do here is drop into code so that you can see how this is implemented in code. Hopefully in the future this will be fixed. So open up the About View Controller class using the Assistant Editor. At the moment you can see it's really empty, there's hardly anything in there. In order to do this, you're going to override ViewDidLoad. And then you're going to set the properties on the stack view itself. Notice that there's an IB outlet called ContentStackView that is linked up to the stack view. The property that you want is called Layout Margins Relative Arrangement. It's a Boolean. By default, it's false. This just tells the stack view, should I pay attention to my layout margins or not? That represents exactly that checkbox that doesn't currently work inside Interface Builder. In order to make this a little bit more obvious, we're going to create some larger content margins than are there by default. Layout Margins is a property on UI View. It takes a UI Edge Insets object. And here I've just set that the top and bottom margins should be 20 points and the left and right should be kept as 0. Now if we build and run, let's just remind ourselves of what it looks like first. This is it currently. Let's build and run and see what the difference is. There we go. You've now got a nice big gap at the top and the bottom. Really simple to do.
That's it for this video tutorial. As always, we like to leave you with a challenge. In the video, you adapted the Detail View controller to have a special layout for compact height. Your challenge is to do the same for the About View controller, to make it look like the one behind me. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you very much for watching, and we'll see you next time.